Hey everybody, welcome to our Wake Up Charlotte to Go, the after show. We are talking Olympics, Olympics, Olympics. So please chime in, let us know what your favorite event was this weekend, what you're looking forward to this upcoming week. But I want to give you just a quick rundown of what's been happening. If you did miss out some this weekend, and so spoiler alerts, if you don't want to know, don't listen. But if you're on social media, you've probably already seen it. In gymnastics, Michaela Skinner taking home silver in vault, and Jade Carey just this morning, gold on the floor, guys. If you watch this weekend, you saw that she had some mistakes in her vault. She was really upset about it. So to see that come back is pretty awesome. And then we found out overnight, Simone Biles will be competing tomorrow morning in B. So that's gymnastics. Now track, Kenny Harrison taking home silver. She is from North Carolina, the 100 meter hurdles. And Anna Cockrell is going to compete tomorrow. And Gabby Cunningham was also in that 100 meter hurdle, taking seventh place. So we are so proud of our local girls, for sure, guys.
For sure. You know, I we should say Anna Cockrell actually just qualified for the finals just a few moments ago. For folks who might have been watching on the streaming, she of course does the 400 meter hurdle. And you know, when it comes to the gymnastics, I think if there's perhaps a silver lining of everything that's happened with Simone Biles over the last weeks, it's that it has allowed some of these other women to really excel and shine in a way they probably wouldn't have otherwise. I mean, I know Michaela Skinner was like on her way back home, was like flying back home when they said she thought she was done with her gymnastics Olympic career. And they called her up and like, actually, we need you to stay and we need you to compete. And here she is walking away with the silver on the vault. When she thought at this point, she's probably gonna be back home in her bed at this point. So if there's a silver lining to that stuff, I'm glad to see some of these other people getting recognition they deserve.
Jay Carey was gold. And Anna, did you mention this about Suni Lee that just came in? Bronze on the uneven?
Nice. No, I didn't know that, Larry.
Yeah, just came in just like maybe 10 seconds ago. So they're winning. They're winning the medals out there. I mean, these women gymnastic team, they're looking fantastic. I think everybody stepped up and just had a great positive attitude and some great support along the way as well.
I love the fact that, you know, all eyes have been on Simone Biles, but just having, you know, teammates to step up to the plate, you know, right behind her, a lot of pressure is on them, not only because, hey, they're getting that last minute call, hey, we need you, you know, but then also you are filling in for Simone Biles, who's been labeled the GOAT, and then you can, you know, really show up for your team. Hey, if you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. And I think those ladies definitely showed that as they are bringing back some medals for Team USA. So definitely go look for Team Gymnastics.
Joy saying she loves gymnastics and swimming. I'm right there with you, Joy. I think one of the greatest things too is that, you know, we haven't really been able to have that with the families hugging and everything. And so now NBC has had this camera where when they interview the athletes afterward, they show a split screen with the families at the same time. And so that you see the athletes getting so emotional, getting to see their family for the first time after they win a medal. And so that's really gotten me too, because you're like there in that intimate moment. Whereas before, if they maybe hugged, you know, their loved one, you saw it, but you weren't like there in the middle of it. And now when they're both staring at the screen, you know, you feel like you're a part of it.
Don't you feel like you said, you can feel it through the screen.
Yes.
Like in so many emotions, just being at the Olympics all together, not having, you know, fans right there, and just thinking about the work that you put in to get to that moment, whether you qualify for Rio or not, just knowing that, you know, a lot of things are coming to fruition for those athletes. It's like you're right there with them, like, you know, rejoicing with them in those moments.
You know, the thing is, this is historical because it's never happened before. And for the first time, they're actually seeing their families. Normally, these athletes have to wait sometimes days, even weeks afterwards before they even see their families. Now it's instantaneous. I think this has been one of the most exciting parts of the Olympics this year. And glad to see that NBC stepped up and made this technology available to all the athletes and the families.
Yeah, you know what? If there's anything disappointing about the Olympics in the last probably 12, 24 hours, It's the women's soccer team.
Yeah.
They lost to Canada, and you know, I mean, the women's soccer U.S. soccer team. I mean, they're like rock stars,
right?
You know, I mean, they have led the way in this sport, and they lost to Canada overnight. So I think this means I think the best they can do is qualify for bronze.
They're going for bronze on Thursday. They can win bronze on Thursday. They can win that one. Hopefully they do. I mean, they're good enough. They're good enough to win the gold medal. So good luck, American soccer. Come on, ladies. You can win.
Right?
Can win.
But if there's anything I feel like we've learned out of this Olympic Games, is you've heard athletes now repeatedly say, we're human. We are not robots. We have good days and bad days. We make mistakes. And we aren't always at our peak at the Olympic Games where, you know, we want to be.
Speaking about bouncing back and just, you know, really doing what you got to do in the moment, Kenny Harris out of Clayton, North Carolina, she placed silver, second place for the 100-meter hurdles. So another Carolina girl putting us on the map. Also, Gabby Cunningham placing seventh in the 100-meter hurdles. And then, obviously, Anna Cockrell from Providence Day. She is moving on to the finals for the 400 meters. So shout out to the girls who are representing the Carolinas. I mean, I just love the fact that while we talk about the Olympics and talk about all the athletes, you know, from different parts of USA, we have so many, you know, plugs right here that we can really just say like, hey, they're right next door to us and they are at, you know, that level in the Olympics that they are placing and bringing home some medals.
By the way, if I can just recommend real quickly, Michael Graff over at Axios Charlotte wrote a phenomenal profile about Anna Cockrell and her family, and specifically her father. He's now an executive at Bank of America, but his humble roots, and now he has three kids, and all of them are excelling exceptionally. He has one in the NFL, one of course at the Olympics, and I think one at the Justice Department. A really neat story about a Charlotte family and how well they're doing.
And I was just going to add to that, Jen.
About these families, so much, literally so much. And it's like you are kind of drawn even more to them after learning their stories, whether, you know, where they came from or who their family members are. So it's like so many takeaways from the Olympics, y'all.
Yeah. When you mentioned Anna, I was going to say for viewers watching, if that name sounds familiar, you know, go online and watch that interview with her right after she found out she qualified for the Olympics. She was crying and she was talking about the struggles that she had. And I believe in 2019 or 2020, she said she didn't even want to be here. So for her to make it to this moment, that was just a really, really powerful interview right after she qualified. So that's who Anna Cockrell is. And we are cheering her on, all going to be watching her tomorrow morning.
Facts. Benicera, y'all know what a track spike is now too from earlier in the show. You can see those shoes that that women wear up until from the 60 meter to the 800 meter. The track spike, I'll have to say, as I ran track and field in college, D1, Coastal Carolina, shout out to them. Those shoes, they're like the narrowest shoe that you can ever think of. And then the spikes on the palm of your foot, it's almost like, I don't want to say that you're walking on pins and needles, but it's not a comfortable shoe, but you definitely get used to it as you run. But shout out to the track girls. This track is just, that's my favorite.
For the folks who missed it, Kirk Gregory, our guy who's been live on the ground there in Tokyo, had the shoe up for Sarah and I this morning, quizzing us what it was for. And actually, Sarah, you guys correctly, you said track and field.
Yes.
Well, I said maybe track or soccer. I knew with the spikes it had to be one of the two. But yeah, I got one of them right. So folks, keep writing below. We want to hear what your favorite moments were over the weekend and what you're looking forward to this week. And of course, we will continue. I can't believe we're on our last week of the Olympic Games, but we'll have it all right here on WCNC Charlotte. Yeah, medal count real quick before we leave.
China's getting close.
China is getting close. We have a 61 total, 21 gold. China has more gold than us, but we have one medal ahead of them, but a lot more up for grabs today and this week. So we'll keep you posted.